Thanks, Nehru. I want to repeat what Nehru said, that it's really a privilege and honor to be here to help honor Murugan. From the very first time I met him, and that was at Tessera, and I'll let Ray say more about that. It was clear to me that there was something special. This clarity of thinking, this ability to distill everything down to what really matters. Within weeks, Murugan knew more about what Tessera was doing and should do and could do than almost anybody else in the organization. And Murugan and I would meet one-on-one to try and understand where Tessera should go, because I looked to his advice. I'll keep it short since time is short today, and I'll let Ray talk about our joint investment in Spike Source, which Murugan co-founded. But when Murugan chose to co-found CK12, I was thrilled. I was thrilled partly because we were supporting CK12, but much more because I felt he, of all people, could make contribution in the open source community in a way that wasn't possible otherwise. The merger of uncertain technology needs, of anticipating the future of technology, the future of open source, how education might come together, is incredibly hard to visualize. And I could think of no other person better than Murugan to do this. Even to this day, no matter what the topic in open source, even last week I sent him a little note saying, hey, how do you compare Udacity and Coursera and edX? There's only one person whose opinion I can truly rely on to be critically objective, to be truly thoughtful and deep. You'd be surprised how many people, even in the business, will give you relatively shallow opinions. In fact, Murugan knows I rely on him on a lot more than open source, and whenever there's a hard software thing to understand, I ask him for his advice. What do you think? If somebody has to do an architectural review of a completely unrelated startup, I ask Murugan for advice. And so it's been truly, because of all this, an honor. Those of you who know me, I'm mostly critical. I mostly critique people for what they can't, they haven't done right. There's very few people I just accept their input, and Murugan is definitely one of those. One of those inputs I seldom question. But there's more than sort of wide understanding of technology. There's much more about predicting the future that I rely on him for. When it's looking at a question like where open source might lead to, his thoughts, his advice is incredibly valuable. But probably more than anything professional is his personal values that I have come to value, his passion. He has such exacting standards. He pushes everything to the hilt because he wants to achieve perfection. It was amazing as I was thinking about Murugan, some of the same phrases that are on that plaque came to mind, even though I hadn't seen the plaque and hadn't heard what was on it. Almost exactly the same phrases. He pushes for perfection with a passion where he cannot tolerate anything not being perfect. It's a characteristic very few people have, and it's the characteristic, this pushing for unreasonable excellence that drives society forward. You know, people like Steve Jobs were examples of that push to the extreme for perfection and not settle for good enough. But even more than that, his other personal qualities mean more to me. One thing I've learned is trust. He may be one of the few people in my professional life, in my personal life, where I never question his motives. And I never question his loyalty. And if he ever were to say, I'm not interested in being loyal to you, I suspect he'd be honest first and tell me that. And those are qualities you really admire. It are things one takes often for granted, but that kind of loyalty and trust is very hard to replicate, that unconditional trust. That is why I consider it a real privilege to be here. That's why I'm really glad that Creative Commons and the Hewitt Foundation and all of you here have come to honor Morgan. Thank you, Morgan, and thank you, Creative Commons.